So, and we are live. Welcome to the Expats Career Webinar. My name is Christian Piak. We will start in about 3 minutes from now on. So if you later watch the recording of this, just jump ahead 3 minutes so you don't waste time with the introductions. I just sent out an invite to my 25,000 readers. They will come now one by one. Join the conversation, and then at 5 p.m. Central European Summer Time is when we will actually start. So bear with me if you are still waiting. We start at 5 p.m. So, I see Kevin is here already from Washington, D.C. Oh, great. Fred Ofosu from Ghana. Hi. V3 Explorer from Frankfurt. Hi. Yeah, people joining. Right now, there's 12 people already in the call, and the other ones will be joining now. One by one, 14 number is going up. As I said before, we will wait till 5 p.m. and give latecomers a little moment so they can catch up with us. Yeah, this will be a fun hour. We will spend maximum 1 hour together. Will be basically two parts. In the first half, I will share some useful insight about the German job market and how to navigate it if you are an international professional who doesn't speak German. And then we will have a short Q&A session in the end where I will answer your questions that you can type into the chat format from the live chat. Okie dokie. So let me prepare a few things while we are still waiting here. Okay. So, there is something that I should have thought of, and that is I can't share my screen with you anymore. Mohamed, hi from Bangladesh, but living in Malaysia. Hello, nice that you meet us. The Fabco Minecraft from Frankfurt, hi. Very nice. So there's 23 people now, and it's 5 p.m., sorry. And I just figured out that YouTube again changed something, and they don't allow me to share my screen with you anymore. But that's not a very big problem because we have a workaround for that. So, yeah, that's kind of funny, and it's not what I expected, okay, but we will work around this. So what we do then is, first of all, welcome to the Expert Career Webinar. Thank you for joining. We will have 1 hour. I will talk with you a little bit about the German job market as it is right now in regard to international professionals like you. And in the end, I will answer some questions that you sent me in the live chat. And what I didn't think of when I set up this meeting beforehand was that YouTube has changed their tools from my end. It was always possible to share your screen when you go live, and they don't allow you to do this anymore, which is pretty stupid if you ask me. But what I will do instead is I will take this little camera here, and one morning moment. See, now we see the beautiful city of Düsseldorf here. And I will put this, fix this here. So you will be able to literally see my screen. talk about a shift mate workaround here. So first of all, send me a little short shout out. Can you hear me well? That would be nice if you write me very quickly in the chat if you can hear what I'm saying, if the microphone connection is good, because anyway, the important thing is the stuff that I will be telling you. Graphics, they are basically just for illustrating what you anyway will hear in the webinar. This is super weird. It's of course not fixating here like it should, but it will in a moment. So that's unusual. If you saw previous webinars from me, you know that's not how I usually do this. But what can you do? You know, you have to go with the flow, as we all have in the last months. Come here. Come. Put. So, well, this way you get a little glimpse of how my office looks like and how I usually work. I wish I could make this more straight. So, okay. I think that's good enough. Are you still with me? Can you hear me? Let me check very quickly. Nada says yes. That's good news. And I will now, for some time, I will not be able to see your questions in the chat, because I will make the PowerPoint presentation big. But in the end, I come and I will answer your questions in the end. Sorry about the confusion. 34 people in the call now. Hello, everyone. I see Nada joined, Vivek, Kumar, Sam, Rashmi, Tushar, Natalia, and several others. Yeah, welcome to the Expert's Career Webinar, and we will start now. This is very unusual. So, here we go now. Are you ready? Welcome to the Expert's Career Webinar 2021. My name is Chris Piak. I'm the author of How to Win Jobs and Influence Germans, the Expert's Guide to a Career in Germany. I literally wrote the book on how you find a job in Germany if you don't fit into the narrow set of expectations of German employers. And before I tell you a little bit about myself and why I feel competent to help you in your quest to find a job here in Germany, today's webinar is a little bit different than the usual webinars that I do. Today's webinar is originally was supposed to promote my expert's career miracle, my expert job offer miracle. When I set this up 4 months ago, the idea was, because I know that people usually decide very late what they actually want to do, that I will do this webinar at the end of August, 1 week before the hiring season starts in September, and then sell you the seats to my coaching program. As it turns out, I sold out all of my coaching seats already a good while ago. So yesterday, in order to not waste this webinar, I created one additional seat so that I could sell it during this webinar. And guess what? This additional seat also has been sold already before the webinar even started. So now I feel already a little bit weird about it, but I created one final seat, the 10th seat, for the Expert Job Offer Miracle. And if you feel during this webinar that you want to be the 10th person to join me, then I suggest you act rather quickly, because I'm 100, excuse me, because I'm 100% sure that this last seat will be sold by the time that the webinar is over. The website where you want to go is immigrantspirit.com/miracle. That's immigrantspirit.com/miracle. Okay, genug about that. Now I mixed German and English. Some good news to start with. This is a headline in Handelsblatt, which is a very prominent German newspaper, kind of like the German version of the Financial Times. From today, the head of the unemployment agency, a government agency, is worried about our lack of skilled labor. We need about 400,000 immigrants every single year just to keep the workforce at the current level. Many people are not aware that Germany is a very old country. We are the second oldest country after Japan. I myself, I'm 47 years old, and I'm still in the younger half of Germans. With 47 years old, I'm still a youngster here in Germany. And that's a huge problem, because way more people retire every year than young people join the labor market, because there are simply too few young people. And in order to fill this gap, we need about 400,000 immigrants every single year just to stay at the current level and to keep our economy going. So this is a problem that has persisted for many years, and that is getting worse and worse every single year. And that obviously is good for you if you're an international professional trying to come to Germany. You know that the trend is on your side. That's some good news to start you with. And the second good news is that it's now end of August. In 1 week, we have the 1st of September. And that's the time during the year between 1st of September and Christmas Eve. That's the time when German companies hire faster than at any other time during the year. And my personal take on that is it's very simple. The managers, they have to defend their budget. And every position that is filled with a coworker, the chances are that this position will not be made redundant. No? So they want to defend their budget. That's why they hire now much faster than during the rest of the year. Yeah, before we start, let me tell you a little bit about myself so you understand why I'm competent to help you find a job in Germany. This is me here, the little guy in the red shirt and the toxic green trousers, celebrating Carnival, a very big thing here in Rhineland, sometime, I think, in the late 70s, early 80s. I'm German. I grew up here in Germany. Out of my 47 years of life, I lived 37 years here in Germany. So I really understand the German culture. I understand how business works here in Germany. And I understand all the unspoken little rules that decide if you move forward here in society or not. But at the same time, I'm just like you, an expatriate. I lived in 5 different countries outside of Germany for more than 10 years. I worked in 4 different cultures, and this really helped me better understand how it feels like to start a career in a completely foreign country, in a completely foreign environment. And it also taught me something that a lot of my compatriots are struggling with, which is that that the German way is not the only way. That people in other countries are also very smart, and they very often have very good solutions that we don't think of. Something that is often quite hard to understand for people who never left their home. Yeah, when I came home to Germany in 2010, I was really shocked, because I was not expecting how little my German compatriots value international experience. Here you see me at the American Women's Club in Düsseldorf. And after my speech, there were two women who came to me who were both crying. I can have that effect on people. And both of them applied to 50 or more positions here in Germany over the course of 1.5, 2 years and didn't get a single interview. And one of them had a degree from the London School of Economics, and the other woman had a degree from Berkeley. Two Ivy League universities, and they were treated in Germany like they were completely uneducated. Nobody was interested in them. This showed me that there is something deeply wrong in German business and society when we let talent like that go to waste. And I decided I want to help to build a bridge between international professionals who want to contribute to our economy here and German employers so that they start to see the value that you can add. I wrote a book about this topic, not out of my own head, but out of years of experience coaching international professionals like you. I'm doing this now for 10 years. I helped over 150 expatriates to find their next job here in Germany. And the things that I learned from working with this very talented, proactive, motivated people, I put in a book that is called How to Win Jobs and Influence Germans. The title is something that Germans never get. That's a pun on Dale Carnegie, of course. You can find it on Amazon, and I really recommend it's a really good reading, and it's in part also quite funny, if I may say so myself. It's no surprise when you do something for a long time and you dig very deep into a topic, you analyze the complete German job market, you have a lot of real-world experiences, both with job seekers on one hand, but also on with German HR professionals and managers on the other hand, that after a while, you are seen as an expert, and newspapers and magazines come to you when they talk mostly about Fachkräftemangel. So I have been covered over the years in a lot of major German newspapers like Handelsblatt, Deutsche Welle, Haufe, Personal, Die Welt, Die Zeit, and quite recently by the BBC about career change. And more interesting, of course, then the stuff that I tell to newspapers is the stuff that you told me over the years. I will share with you now five quotes, actual quotes from expatriates like you who shared their story with me over the years and who I found quite typical. And look at them and maybe you can relate to some of the quotes here. The first one is, of course, the elephant in the room that everyone is talking about, and that is, yeah, without German, it's very hard to get any job interviews. That's not surprising for you. You knew this beforehand. What might surprise you is that I am not worried about your German language skills at all. Because in reality, German is usually not the reason why you can't get a job in Germany. This is something that everybody says because it's a very easy explanation why to reject you, but it is not the real reason. And I proved over 10 years that my coaching clients find jobs in Germany, even though they usually don't speak German at all, and more than half of them don't even live in Germany. They come from all over the world. They come from India, from the United States, for some reason, very often from South Africa, from Australia, from China, everywhere around the world. And they find jobs here in Germany without even speaking German. And you will find out during this webinar why they are successful and how you can imitate them. If you joined us a little bit later, the whole webinar today will run for about 1 hour. I will share some insights about the German job market that are really important to understand if you don't want to continue running against the wall and if you don't want to continue getting rejection after rejection after rejection. I will share what you can do instead, and in the end, I will answer some questions. So this one is a real problem. You apply and you reach out to consultants and to recruiters and so on and so on, and you don't get any answers. Usually, if your profile doesn't fit absolutely exactly to what a headhunter is looking for right now, reaching out to headhunters is a waste of time. Because for you, for them, you are a source of income. And if they can't monetize you right away, then they are not interested. The same goes, by the way, for the Initiativbewerbung. If you make your own application to a company, even though they don't have a fitting job to offer right now, that goes right into the spam filter. No one cares. No? They are very busy. They have stuff to do. And they look for the things that can solve the problem that they have right now. They're not interested to hear from you if you don't have a solution to the actual problems that they have in this very moment. Here we're getting closer to the actual core of the problem, and that is that you apply and you apply and you apply, and you never get a good explanation why you don't fit. And because you don't get an explanation, you cannot improve, you cannot adapt, you cannot change, and therefore you are forced to always to repeat the same mistakes. Because no one is ever giving you an honest answer. Because either you don't get an answer at all, or you get some bullshit answer like, you need German, or you are overqualified, or sorry, we went in a different direction, or we found some other candidates. No? What you don't get is a really honest answer. When I talk to HR professionals, and I talked to over 1,000 over the years, with me, they give an honest answer, because I will not sue them if they tell me the real reason why they reject you. And I will come to one of the main reason why so often international professionals get rejected in a moment. Yeah, again, we come a little bit closer to the real reason. I have a great career, writes this person, 13 years of experience, but not in this very exact industry. And therefore, they are very reluctant to talk to me. So if you are not a complete perfect fit, then many HR people, many recruiters are simply not interested. And because of all of this, you don't get job interviews. And if you don't get a job interview, how are you gonna prove yourself? How can you prove your value if you never have the chance to talk to an actual person? And that's at the core of why anybody who is different in any way struggles so much in Germany. Because you are seen as a stereotype and you're not seen as the concrete professional that you are, and you have no chance to prove how you could contribute to a position. Yeah, which brings us very, very close to the core problem that is really holding you back. There's a hidden obstacle that actually kills you. The other things like, you are from a different industry, or you just had a baby, and how will you manage with this challenge, or you were out of a job because you got a baby, or you have the exact right qualification and experience in the industry, but it was not in Germany, it was in a different country. All these things, they are not the real reason why you don't get a job. The real reason is a hidden obstacle that I will show you today. And of course, I will also give you a hint about how you can overcome this obstacle. So, and this obstacle has something to do with this young lady here. This is a survey by the Institut zur Zukunft der Arbeit. That's a government agency who is researching the labor market here in Germany. And they wanted to test how important is prejudice when candidates want to get a job interview in a company. So they sent out three sets of job applications to 1,500 companies. And each of these three sets of each 500 applications was completely identical. It was always the very exact same person with the same background, the same education, everything. And let me be very clear. We are talking here about a German citizen, a German person who grew up in Germany, who speaks fluent German, who went through the German school system and university and has work experience only in German companies. But they changed two things. In the first one, they sent the application with a German sounding name, Sandra Bauer. In the second set of 500 applications, they changed only one thing, and that was the name from Sandra Bauer to Meryem Öztürk, a name that's not traditional Germany, even though she is a German. And in the last set, they changed the name and they changed the picture so that the woman in the application wears a headscarf. So how did this affect the chances to get a job interview? And always keep in mind, these are not foreigners. This is a German person who grew up here in Germany with a German education, everything as everybody else here. Well, the typical German, Sandra Bauer in this case, she had to send on average 5 applications to get 1 job interview. Meaning out of a set of 500 applications that were sent for Sandra Bauer, there were 100 job interviews. How about Meryem Öztürk? Same person, exact same CV, same picture, just the name is different. And the number of applications she has to send to get job interviews increased by nearly 50% to 7.5 applications for 1 job interview. So someone with the name Meryem instead of Sandra has to do a lot more work to get the same result, even though the qualification is exactly the same. So what happens now if Meryem is shown with a headscarf on her picture? She has to send 23 applications just to get 1 job interview. So to put this into perspective for you, Meryem with a headscarf sent out 500 applications, and she ended up with 17 job interviews. And Sandra, with a German name and no headscarf, sent out 500 applications and gets 100 job interviews. Let that sink in. This is a very German answer now. You see, that's the core problem that you are facing. That when you reach out through the usual channel and you send your usual application, you are judged by people who are extremely set in their way. You are judged by people who basically looking for a small copy of the last person they hired for the job. And if you are different in any way, then you get sorted out. And there is research that shows that HR recruiters in Germany, they will look at your CV for an average of 7 to 12 seconds. In other words, within 7 to 12 seconds, they decide if they read your CV or if they reject your CV. And the default answer is always to reject your CV. Why? Because they are looking for a clone. They don't looking for you, and they are not interested what you actually have to offer. They're looking to hire the exact same person that they last hired in this shop. And if you are just in the slightest bit different, then you get rejected. And this can be that you are a foreigner. This can be based on race, that your skin is a little bit darker, but it can as easily be that you are too young, you are too old, you're the right age, but oh my God, you are a woman and you might want to have children very soon. Or you can't know exactly how to do this job, but you did this job in a different industry, or any other things, how you deviate from a imaginary norm that doesn't really exist. It just exists in the head of the HR person. And that's a very hard truth that you need to accept before you can adjust your strategy so that you can successfully navigate in this German environment and still get the job that you so rightfully deserve. Because I know after working 10 years with international professionals, how great your expertise is, how great your education is, and how much you have to contribute. But it doesn't go with just sending your CV. That just goes right into the reject folder. Because no matter how hard you try, you will never ever look like these people. And from the bottom of my heart, let me tell you, I'm so glad that you don't, because we have enough of them. We need people who are different. I argue for 10 years already that international professionals can actually be a great contribution to Germany. I think what we need is exactly people from the outside who help us to adapt and to change and to be successful in a world that is changing at an ever-increasing pace. But the people you meet in HR departments are usually different. There, I'm very sorry to say, and I know now there's some HR person listening to this webinar who will write me very angry emails. It's always the case. But the truth is that people who work in HR in Germany, they are often have a certain personality. They are the key people who otherwise would work for the government. They are mostly concerned with being safe. That's the number one goal in life. And they don't want the company to be safe. They want themselves to be safe. And that means they don't want to be criticized. So if you come around and you are not from Germany, you don't speak our language, you went to a university that they have never heard of, you worked for employers that we don't know here in Germany, and you're not exactly like the last 10 people she hired, what will a person do whose number one goal in life is to avoid risk? Will she take the risk to go with this really strange person who is super different, or will she avoid the risk? Of course she avoids the risk, and you are out. So in other words, for most international professionals, simply applying to the typical application process is a waste of time. Because there's basically exactly two scenarios. Number one, and that goes for 96% of all companies in Germany, they are German language companies who work in German, and if you are different, they are afraid of you and they will reject you. And then there's the 4% of German companies who actually work in English, and they get immense amount of applications. I interviewed Zalando for my podcast recently. They get over 100,000 applications every single year. Lilium, you might have noticed that I have a really soft spot in my heart for Lilium. They also get 100,000 applications per year. They are not that big, but they have a really amazing product. So lots of talented people want to work for them. Trivago, I used to work for them when I started out. They get 40,000 applications every single month. So if you are not the absolute top of the top, your chances to land a job in one of these companies is very, very slim. So what's the solution? If you can't win with HR, if you can't win with the typical application process, the solution is, I think we should see other people. It's true in dating, and it's also true when you're looking for a job. If the people that you are talking to right now are completely uninterested in you and they don't care about you at all anymore, then you need to talk to other people and to different people. That's what really makes the difference. I believe that the best thing that can happen to Germany is people like you come to our country and contribute to our economy and our society. Because Germany has to change or we will not be successful in the future. And this cartoon by Markus Reif, a very renowned HR speaker here in Germany, an influencer, really is spot on. Why don't we have any fresh ideas around here? Well, because you hire only people who are exactly the same as you are yourself. So we need different people. We need people like you. How do you find these people that are interested in you? Well, you need to ignore HR, completely ignore HR, and instead you seek out the people who are interested in the golden eggs that you can deliver, who care more about your contribution than about the obstacles to hiring you. And who are these people? They are the managers, the hiring managers, the person that you will report to if you get, if you get the job. That's the solution that works for everyone who is the slightest bit different. It's not only international professionals who face this obstacle of getting into the German job market, but you are an extreme case. It's also the same for everybody who has been out of a job, for every woman who has been out of a job for a few years because she got children, for everyone who is already a little bit older or who wants to change careers. The BBC published an article some while ago where they quote me as an expert exactly because of that, because exactly I have experience in helping people who don't fit into an imaginary ISO norm to break into an industry. You can seek it out when you Google BBC and Chris Piak. Yeah. This is the Tesla semi-truck, and maybe you wonder why I come to that right now. When you seek out the hiring manager to talk to, then you need to talk with him about things that she or he is interested in. Why is the hiring manager the right person to talk to? Well, because they care. HR doesn't care. If they go home at the end of the day, they didn't hire anybody, doesn't affect their job. But the hiring manager has problems to solve, goals to achieve, deadlines to meet. They care about your contribution. So when you have a chance to get a hiring manager on the phone, this is what usually happens. And it's very natural. I'm not making fun of this and I'm not blaming anyone. It's a very natural thing. The thing that most people do is they are so relieved that finally they get to talk to someone that they push all their information out there. And they talk about themselves all the time, why they want to come to Germany, what they did in their life, why they dream about starting in this company, blah, 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 blah. It's very natural, but it's also the worst thing you can do. Because it's very hard to get a hiring manager on the phone. And if you do, you cannot waste your time talking about yourself. Because you always need to be aware of how much time do I have with this person. Usually it will be like 30 minutes. Sometimes it will be only 5 minutes that you can talk to this person. So you want to talk in this conversation about the things that really move the needle, that really make the hiring manager decide, oh, I need to invite this person for a job interview because I want to have a longer conversation with her. Now, my number one $1 million question. What do you think makes a hiring manager decide that they want to talk to you for a job interview? Is it anything you want to say? Or is it something that the hiring manager cares about? The hiring manager is the one who decides if you get a job. So the only thing that actually matters is what the hiring manager wants. So if you get a hiring manager on the phone, or you meet him in person, or you have any chance to converse with him, don't tell, don't talk about yourself, not at all. Instead, ask questions. And that's why the Tesla Semi truck is here. You see, when Elon Musk decided to build a truck, an electric truck, he didn't go out and designed an awesome truck and then presented it to the world. Instead, what he did was, before he even did one little thing of work on this truck, he went out and seeked out all his potential customers, all the logistics companies, all the big supermarkets with warehouses, and so on and so on. And he asked all of them, hey, what's your problem? What is the biggest problem in trucking, in deliveries, that we could solve for you? And only when he really understood the needs of the customer and the pain of the customer, and with the employer is the same, then he formulated a solution. And I want to show you how deep into detail this research went. One of the things that Elon Musk's potential customers told him was that in trucking, a big problem is that the windshields of the trucks will usually break about once per year. And this causes a lot of problem, you know, downtime, deliveries are too late, there are penalties to pay, there's all the hustle of repairing the windshield, blah, 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 blah. No? So lots of stuff that are really difficult for the customers. And when Elon Musk designed the Tesla Semi truck, he designed it so that the windshield will never break. He joked at the presentation that he will give a guarantee that the windshield will withstand a nuclear blast, which of course he is not serious about. But if a nuclear blast hits, then you can't take the guarantee anymore because you are gone, you know. So, but this is the level of details you need to dig into if you really want to make a successful pitch. And the biggest challenge I often see over and over and over with candidates is that their applications are super generic. They know nothing about the company they apply for. They know nothing about the concrete manager and what keeps this manager, your future boss, alive. Now imagine you and I both apply for the same job. And you have a great expertise. And you send your CV in. And I have an okay expertise, but I talk to the manager before I apply. And because I talk to him, I know that this thing is a very big worry for him. The windshield gets broken once per year. And I can, in my application, tell him, hey, I know this is what you care about, this broken windshield. And this is how I helped other people in the past to fix their windshield and to make sure that it will not break again. Who do you think will get the job? The person who talks in generic terms, mostly about themselves, or the person who is talking about the manager and his or her problems? The second person wins every single time. Because when you apply for a job, you don't apply for a company, you apply for a person. Reid Hoffman, the founder of LinkedIn, has a great quote that I often use. Opportunities do not float like clouds in the sky. They are connected to people. If you're looking for a job, you're actually looking for a person with a problem. Because that's all a job is. Someone has a problem and they hire someone to fix the problem. So first find the person, then find the problem. And you find it by asking, not by telling, and then offer a solution based on your work experience. That's how you get a job. And I know this works because I do this for 10 years and I have helped over 150 people who mostly didn't even live in Germany at the time to find a job here in Germany. Some of the quotes from this year already from the first half. You find here, these are a couple of my clients who wrote me back that they already found a job. By the way, very good news here, and for me, very surprising. When COVID hit Germany, I was really worried, and I thought this would be very, very difficult now for international professionals. The opposite is true, and I will get to that in a moment. Here's one thing that I want you to understand. Yes, in Germany, there is lots of open jobs. Last year, there were 8.7 million job ads in Germany. And duplicates are already sorted out here. 8.7 million jobs were offered during the last year here in Germany. But if you look only for the jobs that are offered in English, the number was only 464,000, roughly 5%. 5% of all job ads in Germany were in English. Way, way less than the total numbers of jobs. And you are mostly competing for these English jobs right now, but you could compete for the whole 8.7 million if you approach it a little bit different than you are used to. Yeah, I started to share one thing that I learned over the last 9 months. And that is, I was really afraid that COVID would make it much, much harder for people who are different. I'm very happy to say that the opposite is true. You know, for 10 years, I researched the internet, I researched the German job market together with a company called TechKernel. And I analyze all the jobs that are on offer in Germany. And I analyze all the companies who offer these jobs. And for 10 years, it was always only about 1%, 1% of German companies that hire in English. Only 1%. And then COVID hit in March last year. And we all went from looking like this to looking like that. This was, that's not dandruff in my hair, that's was photographed in February when we had snow. Just want to point that out. And something really weird happened. Maybe the one good thing that happened in all this terrible mess of COVID, and that is that suddenly German employers were willing to change. We went from, no, you can never work in home office. It would never work. It would be impossible to maintain. To, of course, everybody working in home office. Here you see the numbers from before the pandemic to during the pandemic. Before the pandemic, 61% of Germans were not allowed to work in home office. Once the pandemic hit, 61% were working in home office. And the effect, by the way, was so great that ADAC, that's a very powerful German car owner association, they did research and found out that the traffic jams in Germany reduced by 50% in 2020 because everybody was at home. No? So German employers learned that, yes, you can do things differently and the world doesn't end. You can do things differently, and things might actually get better. And because they are realizing this in one area, in home office, some of them are now willing to try this out in a different area as well and hire in English as well. So during the last quarter of 2020, the number of English job ads in Germany, sorry, of English, of companies that hire in English, that advertise in English, went from 1% to 4%. 10 years, nothing moved. Then within a few months, the number of companies who offer jobs in English quadrupled, four times more. Still extremely low, but there's some movement there. And I also see this in my work. I take on new clients two times per year. On 1st of February, I start the expert job offer by summer program. And on 1st of September, now in 1 week, I start the expats job offer by Christmas program. And this summer, also basically from February on till middle of June or July, I was so surprised because my clients, they all find jobs, but it usually takes a while. No, that's why the summer program is a little bit longer than the Christmas program, because during Christmas time, companies hire faster between Christmas and between September and Christmas, they hire faster. But this spring and summer, I got lots and lots of messages like these. People found jobs super fast. The fastest person here in my summer program found a job within 2 weeks. That's something that I have seen only a handful of times during my 10 years of experience. And all the others, they found jobs really fast. I was really positively surprised and also quite happy because it meant that I could have a little bit more time with my family during this really hard COVID time. Yeah, so Germany changed a little bit, but it needs to change a lot more. And knowing the German national character, I advise you to seize the moment, seize this opportunity, because right now we slowly started to move. And it's easier when you already started to move, it's easier to make the second step as well and try again something new and again something new. But if you wait until this COVID crisis is over, then whatever we do at that point in time will be the new normal. And then again, it will take 10 or 20 years before things will start to change again. That's unfortunately true about Germany. So use this opportunity, this little openness to change that we have right now. Use it now, seize the moment, because it will be gone maybe faster than we thought. Yeah, how can I help you with this? That's, of course, the question that I'm here to answer. Not only did I write a book that you can read and a step-by-step guide to a career here in Germany, but also, of course, I have some credibility here in Germany because I do this for a long time. A lot of people know me either through working with me when I place candidates or because they read my articles. Or they read about me in some news outlets like BBC or Handelsblatt or somewhere else. But also, I am, of course, quite well connected here in Germany because I lived here most of my life. And I worked with a lot of companies and helped them find good candidates. And that's, I think, the main benefit I can give you. There's two things I can do for you. The number one is that I can guide you through this German business culture and help you navigate it in a way that works in the German business culture so that you don't waste your time running against a wall over and over and over and over again when two steps from you, there's a door that is open. No? So that's the number one thing I will do for you. I guide you really step by step along the way and one-on-one. But the second thing is, of course, that I have something that you don't. If you come from outside here to Germany, you have very little contacts. You have very little connections. And that means there are very little people who will be willing to vouch for you. And for me, it's the exact opposite. I live here all my life. With 10 years exception, I was always here. I know thousands of people who have first-hand experience with me, and the thousands of people are connected to a half a million other people who they can introduce me to, and those people are actually literally connected to millions. This is an actual screenshot from my Xing account. It's already, a year old or so. By now, I have way more connections. So, if you want my help to find a job in Germany, if you want me to guide you step by step and to be in your corner and do everything that is necessary, whatever it takes to help you get a job between 1st of September and Christmas Eve. Then head over now to immigrantspirit.com/miracle, and there you can book the last available seat of the Expat Job Offer by Christmas program. It's called the Expats Miracle. That's the whole program during the year, and it's divided into two branches. The Expat Job Offer by Summer program that starts in 1st of February, and the Expat Job Offer by Christmas program that starts in 1st of September, in case you listen to this webinar at a later point in time. Yeah, that's from my side from today. If you go over to immigrantspirit.com/miracle, maybe you can do this right now. Go to the website and I will show you one thing that you that's useful for you. Maybe open your browser and go to immigrantspirit.com/miracle. If you go there, you find a website that looks like this. And if you scroll down quite a good time down there, then you find a calendar embedded into the website. And if you switch the months from August, which we have now, to September, then you find dates that are available, that I am available for a coaching session. And if you want to join my program, you can book your first coaching session, the day and the time of your choosing, right there on the calendar. It will take you to all the steps, and you can pay in the calendar form via PayPal for the first installment of your coaching. I work with a limited number of clients every single year, and I take on clients in February, and I take on clients in September, and each seat is always more expensive than the previous one. And as it happens in this webinar, I sold all the seats already before the webinar. That's why I created one additional place. So if you want to take it, be fast, because there's, I don't know, 40, 45 people in this call right now, and one of them for sure will buy it. I have no doubt about that. Great. So thank you for bearing with me. Let's go back and answer a few of your questions. So let's escape here. Shoop, let me see where you are. Here, great. So, again, hoochdi. Sorry for this really weird format. YouTube got me there because they are changing all the way how this works. So, but I'm here now to answer a few of your questions. You can write them in the live chat. By the way, there's 42 people right now in the chat. I thank all of you for your participation. So if you want to buy the last remaining seat, I would suggest you act now. I will post the link also in the live chat right now. But feel free to send me your questions that you have. Now I will answer three questions, I think, and then we call it a day and move on from there. Who has the first question? Bazam writes, 4% of English open jobs against millions of English applicants. That's exactly true. There's actually more than 1.2 million people moving to Germany every single year. Even during COVID, more than a million came because most are European Union citizens and they can move very easily to us. So the first question comes from Tushar. I've been working in Germany since more than 2.5 years as a researcher. Now I want to transition into the energy industry from university-based research, not getting much interviews. Yeah, Tushar, your challenge is the very typical challenge, meaning you are different. In this case, what is different is that your expertise was in academia, and now you want to work in business. So again, they perceive you as different, and you need to somehow overcome that. Sending an application will not do you any good in most cases. A better way is when you find a job offer that you are interested in, identify the actual hiring manager, the person that you will report to if you get this job. And that's what I can teach you. That's what I do as part of the Expat Job Offer Miracle. I help you to, I teach you how to identify the actual decision makers behind a job offer. And then you reach out to this hiring manager for a conversation. And when you are in the conversation with the hiring manager, you ask him about her or his biggest problem and why this problem is so important. And I guarantee you, you will not hear anything that you have never dealt with, because most problems are actually always the same. I'm 100% sure that the manager will have a problem that you have experienced in the past and that you have dealt with in the past. And what you can do then is, when you really understand the problem and why it is important, you share an experience of your own work life where you solved a similar problem. And that gets you the credibility that you need, that you will get a proper job interview. Because in the end, the only thing that is important is, can you solve the manager's problem or not? Okay, Tarini writes, hi, I've got a residency rights in France to my husband when we applied before the 31st of December last deadline. Can I apply for a German job? I am not British, but my hubby is. Since Brexit, of course, British people are also not EU citizens anymore. So even if you're married to a Brit, he and you would still have to apply for a visa when you come to Germany. But if you have a university degree, then you can apply for a blue card, which is actually quite simple. Unfortunately, a living permit in France is not immediately transferable to Germany, because these are still different countries. I personally would prefer, if you have a EU-wide blue card that allows you to work everywhere in the EU, but as so often, the national governments are still blocking that. But I wouldn't worry too much about that. If you can make, if you have something to offer to the German job market, then you will still be able to find a great job here in Germany if you follow my advice and ignore HR and talk to the hiring manager. Visa is always something you can deal with. The general problem with every obstacle, by the way, every obstacle that there is to hiring you, you can try to minimize the obstacle, but even if it's a small obstacle, people will not be able to work with you on this if they are not first convinced that you really have to give them something. So the best strategy is not to minimize obstacles to hiring you. The best strategy is to maximize the value that you bring to a company. Sorry, the value that you bring to a manager. And the best way to maximize the value is to know exactly, in detail, what the manager really wants and why he wants it. And that you only find out by asking. Jamini22, do you believe there is a chance for someone coming from oil and gas? I am an engineer and pursuing my MBA as well. Is there any oil and gas happening in Germany? In this industry, it will be very hard, because we are going away from oil and gas. We are never that strong into this industry anyway. Russia is, of course, a European country where this is much more prominent, and we are moving away from this. So in the next 10 years, a lot of these jobs will disappear. So it would be better if you find a way how you can use your skills as an engineer and transfer them to other areas that are coming up, like renewable energies, batteries, and of course also cleaning up all the mess from the existing oil refineries, for example. Now, that could be an area, because all these oil refineries, they have to be built. The area has to be cleaned up and renaturalized. And there your expertise might be valuable. Okay. Hakan86, I have graduated from Berlin in May 2020. Congratulations. I come from sales engineer experience. Very good. And have worked in the oil and gas industry. Yeah, I answered that already. Yes, sir. Tumal Pali, hello. I have been in Germany for 2 years, from 2014 to 16, as a Catholic priest. After changing my career, I have been working for 2.5 years and working as a DevOps engineer. What will be my hurdles to move to Germany? Engineers are in high demand. You have already 2.5 years of experience. And you have a really interesting and unusual story to tell. So I think you have actually quite good prospects. If you can make yourself seen as a person, as a professional, and not just as a stereotype or a CV. So I think if you manage this hurdle to actually get managers into a conversation with you, I think you have really good opportunities to come to Germany. And I would be glad to help you achieve this goal. Great. Yeah, I think that's a very good point to end. I thank all of you very much for your time and that you bared with me through this weird technical problems that we had today. Let me put my camera around again so you can see me for the band. Oopadi, da bin ich wieder. So, yeah, thank you all for bearing with me through this weird technical situation today. It's very unusual. And I would love to be working together with you, helping you to find a job in Germany. Now is the time. Between September and Christmas Eve, German employers hire faster than at any other time during the year. They all have to defend their budget and they all want to fill all the open positions that they have so that they don't get budget cuts. If you want to work with me, go to immigrantspirit.com/miracle. I will also post the link in the live chat one more time. And if you watch this at a later time, then this link will lead to whatever program is active at this time. So if you watch it in January next year, it will lead to the summer program. If you click it now, it leads to the Christmas program. Thank you all and goodbye.